Hello and welcome to this session on Catalan Studio. And today we are going to see the new release of Catalan Studio, that is version 5.5. And as of now, it is still in beta stage. So if you go to your Catalan Studio and go to the resources and go to documentation, and here, when you go to this release notes page, you can see the latest version is 5.4. So version 5.5 is still not officially available, but you can see the here is a link, and I will make this link available in the description of this video as well, from where you can get the beta release of version 5.5. And here are the links to get Catalan Studio version 5.5 for your operating system. So whatever your operating system is, you can get and download Catalan Studio 5.5 from here. And here are the highlights of this version. So let me show you what has changed and what is new you will get in version 5.5. So I am going to show this on a Mac system. However, whether you are on Windows or Mac, you can follow it along. So here I am going to start a earlier version of Catalan Studio, which is 5.4. So this will start 5.4, and on a new desktop, I will start Catalan Studio 5.5 that I have just downloaded from these links. So I have downloaded the macOS link. You can get the Windows or Linux as per your operating system. So here we have version 5.4.2 of Catalan Studio, and on this particular desktop we are starting version 5.5. So you can see this is version 5.5 beta, and let me just log in. Okay, now the very first difference that you will see is on the help screen that comes up when you start your Catalan Studio. You can see some different sample projects. If you go to the earlier version 5.4, we had a sample web testing project, sample web services, and sample mobile testing project. And when you click on more, it takes you to this GitHub page where you have all these sample projects. Now in case of Catalan Studio 5.5 beta, you can see there are some different projects, sample projects here. We have a Jira API test, we have a Jira UI test, we have data-driven tests, we have iOS and Android mobile test. And when you go to explore, it takes us to a different GitHub page where we have all these sample projects of Catalan Studio. So this was the very first difference. Let us now see the main differences. The very first is improve web recorder. So let us see what has changed in the web recorder. If you go to the new version, so let me just go and create a new project. So I'm going to new and create a new project here in Catalan Studio 5.5, and I will say this is demo project 1 and say okay. And I'm going to do the same on version 5.4 as well. I will go to file and new project, and I will say this is demo project 2 and say okay. Okay, so we have a new project created on both the versions. Now when you go to this record web here, so let us go here on version 5.5, and you can see here is a little different recording UI, and that is the very first difference. You can see the improved web recorder. The new web recorder will have a similar interface to test case view, and it is also equipped with the ability to execute recorded steps on the fly. So let me just show you. So you can see this is the new UI. If you go to the earlier Catalan Studio version and go to record web, you can see this is the UI of the record web. We just had this single section, and now we have this section, and then at the bottom we have variables and logs. So let us just record something and see. On the new version, I will select Chrome and I will start my recording. So it has started a Chrome browser, you can see at the background, and it by default goes to this website, which is the demo website of Catalan Studio. So let us just use this. I'm going to click on make appointment, and let me just use some dummy username and password and click on login, and I will just close this. So you can see everything is getting recorded here, and when I will close, it has also recorded close browser here. Now the same thing if I do here on the older version, that is 5.4, I will give the URL here and click on any browser, Chrome I'm selecting here, and it will again start a Chrome browser at the background, you can see. And here I will again record some actions. I will record the same actions. So I will click on make appointment and again give some dummy username and password and click on login, and then just close this. So one thing you must have noticed is when I close the browser, it did not record close browser action. However, in the new Catalan Studio 5.5 beta, it has recorded close browser, and again it starts with an open browser and then navigates to URL. However, in the earlier version, it starts directly with navigate. So that was one difference. And the other difference you can see is here we have this run button, so you can run this on the fly and check your recording before you integrate with your test case. So here in the new version, I can click run, and also it has a drop down where you can select run all steps or run only the selected step or run from the selected step. So you can select some steps and then you can run it, and you can also select multiple steps by pressing control or command key on your keyboard. And here I'm going to run all the steps, so I will say run all steps and click on run, and you can see a Chrome browser at the background which is running our test. And here you can also see the logs, so this is a additional thing that you can see the logs here as well, and this will be very handy while you are creating your test cases through recording. And this is done, and you can see it shows the overall status. So there was some error, and here it shows the overall status as error. And then of course you can look at the logs and do the troubleshooting, and once you are satisfied that everything is okay, you can click the OK button and then add the objects to the object repository. You can create a new folder or add in the default folder and say OK, and you can give the name to the test. I will say test 1, and you can say OK. It will create the new test with the recorded steps. So you can see our new test is created with the recorded steps. The other major feature of Catalan Studio 5.5 version is you can share your custom keywords. So here if you go to file, you will find a option for import keywords, and here you have option to import from a folder which can be your local folder, or you can also get it from Git. So if you go to folder, you can actually browse from your local system, and if you say import keywords from Git, you can actually get it from your GitHub, and you can give your repository URL, and hence you can also share your keywords. If you go to the older version, which is 5.4, there is no option like import keywords. So that is one new change. And then the other major thing is extend web service object. So enhancement within the web service object view to help you execute your verification snippets on the fly. So this is something very important and very useful. Let me show you. Let me just take an example of a REST API or a REST web service. So here is a URL or the endpoint of a REST web service. Let me go to the older version and actually create a new object for API. So I will go to file, new, and I'm going to create a web service request, or let me go to object repository, and here I can create a web service request. So I will just leave it as it is, the names by default, and say OK. And here let me give the URL and run this. So before actually I run this, let me show you the interface on the new Catalan Studio as well. So here again I will go to new. On the object repository, I will go to new and create a web service request and keep the names as it is, and again give the URL here, the same URL. Now if you look at the initial UI, you would not find a major difference, but if you see here, there is a verification tab here as well as a verification log here, which is missing in the earlier version. So now let me show you the advantage of this. When I run this, I can save this and run this. You will see if you go to the verification tab, Here are these snippets that you can directly use to create your test scripts. So for example, if I say get current response, if I click here, you can see a new snippet has been created here, and this I can use directly into my test. I can make updates to this and I can use this. Similarly, I just want to check status code is 200. So here is the snippet of checking status code is 200. I will just use this and I have got the snippet. And then here is the verification log. So if I run this now, and if you go to verification log, you will find the results here. As of now, I'm not getting anything, so that might be because this is a beta version and there might be some fixes needed. But yes, this is something very important while you are creating your web services test cases. You can directly create some very quick scripts, testing scripts from here. And this kind of feature is available in Postman. If you go to Postman, and here I can just create a new request. So I will just use the same endpoint and say send. And here we have got the response. And here again, you can see we have a tab for tests. If I go here, you can see here are the snippets. So this feature is something very much similar to what is already available in Postman. So again, if I say status code is 200, it creates a snippet for this. So this is something similar what we have got here, but this is going to be very useful, and it is very good that Catalon team has added this feature in the new version of Catalon Studio. So these are the major improvements and highlights of 5.5 version, and of course there are some issue fix that you can go through it. And I hope this was very useful for you, and I'm waiting for an official release of Catalon Studio 5.5. This is going to be very useful and helpful for our automation testing. I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching.